हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू राहगीर इंडिया डिफेंस अड्डा, जहां पर आपको एसएसबी और डिफेंस रिलेटेड सारा इन्फॉर्मेशन और वीडियोस अवेलेबल हैं। इसके साथ में ही हमारा 15 डेज का एसएसबी गाइडेंस कोर्स है, जिसे देखकर आप अपनी पूरी की पूरी गाइडेंस कर सकते हैं और अपने आप को एसएसबी के लिए तैयार कर सकते हैं। साथ में ही हमारी वेबसाइट में कुछ बुक्स हैं जो कि आप अपनी गाइडेंस के लिए यूज़ कर सकते हैं। दोस्तों, आज के सेशन में हम एक कैंडिडेट का लाइव इंटरव्यू करेंगे और उनसे कुछ ऐसे क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे जो कि आपसे पूछे जा सकते हैं, और आप इन्हें ध्यान से देखें और एनालाइज करें कि किस तरह से आंसर देना चाहिए और किस तरह से आंसर नहीं देना चाहिए।
ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग रितु, हाउ आर यू?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर, आई एम गुड।
ओके, टेल मी थ्री थिंग्स व्हिच हैव हैपेंड इन लास्ट वन वीक व्हिच यू हैव टेकन नोट ऑफ।
या आई गेस रिसेंटली द राफेल हैज बीन ऑफिशियली इंडक्टेड इन द इंडियन एयरफोर्स and the DRDO has successfully launched the demo vehicle for hypersonic technology, and there is ongoing tension in the Pangong lake in Ladakh going on, and yes sir.
Okay, good, that's fine. Okay, tell me something about your early life, your childhood, your education, your parents, your colleagues, your marks you scored, and how was your relationship with your colleagues?
Okay, sir, I belong to a place, Barwala, Hisar, Haryana. My early childhood was in Barwala itself, and I studied in Vishwas High School till my 10th class. And after that, I opted for non-medical stream and went for government girls senior secondary school in Barwala. That was two in Barwala. And after that, I went for higher education in Chandigarh and choose the BSc non-medical as my subjects. After that, I opted for MSc chemistry honors and studied in Punjab University, Chandigarh. And the percentage I scored in 10th class is 98%, and in 12th, I scored 91% of marks. In BSc, I scored 73.45%, and in MSc, I scored 62.45% of marks. And if I talk about my family, yeah, if I talk about my family, we are 7 members in the family. My father, my mother, and we are 5 siblings. And my father is a businessman, and my mother is a homemaker. My elder brother is a chartered accountant, and my younger sisters are studying in MCOM, and my youngest brother is studying in school in 9th class. And yes, sir.
That's all. Okay, I saw that you're talking about your percentages. You dropped from 90 something to 60 odd percent. That's a huge drop, almost 30% marks drop. What was the reason? Were you doing something wrong at that time? What happened?
Sir, I scored very less percentage of marks during the first semester of my MSc. I scored only 46% in that semester. The reason behind this was, sir, I was a little bit overconfident in the first semester. I thought like I will study in the last days of my examination and will clear it. But unfortunately, that does not happen. And I realized my mistake later on and cover up my percentage in the rest of the semesters.
But were you doing something wrong? What were you doing during all that time?
I was not doing anything wrong, but I was just not focusing on my studies at that time. And I was a little bit more indulged in internet surfing. And I used to watch a lot of YouTube videos at that time. But later on, I realized this mistake. And in rest of the semester, I managed to score more than 65% of marks. That's so I made a decent aggregate of 62% overall.
Okay, what type of YouTube surfing and videos you used to watch at that time?
Sir, I used to watch the interviews of famous personalities. I watched the stand-up comedies and educational videos also. All these types of video I used to see.
Okay, tell me the three major personalities which you have watched and which have motivated you. Three personalities.
Okay. Sir, I watched the interview of Annu Kumari, that was a UPSC topper last 2 years back. and she was very encouraging personality. She managed to do to get a rank of second rank in IES, despite she was a mother of a 2 years child. And the one more interview that I remember was the interview of Kangana Ranaut. She was really an inspiration for all the girls. And and third interview I watched was the that was also the UPSC topper Kanishk Kataria, and he was also a motivation for all the students who are preparing for the competitive examinations.
Okay, tell me something about life of Jeff Bezos. Life history and the work and the culture, how he's come up till this. Tell me something about him.
Sir, he is the founder of Amazon, and he started his career from a very low basic. He started his career at a garage, and slowly it becomes an overall brand, and he is the richest person in the whole world. And yes, sir.
That's all. What are the three things which you learned from him that you shouldn't be doing?
Sorry, sir.
What are the three negative things which you learned from him that you should avoid in your life?
Yes, I don't know, sir.
Okay, no problem. Let's come to your personal things. You spoke about your brother who's a chartered accountant. What have you learned from him till now?
Sir, as I know him, that he from the school, he was a very average student, but he is very determined in nature. And being an average student, he is very successful in his career. He managed to be a chartered accountant, and at present he is earning very very well and is very successful in his life. So the thing that I learned from my brother is to be determined and to how to be motivated towards one's career. Yes.
Okay. Did you learn anything about finance from him? Okay. What is a financial statement?
Sir, I don't know.
Okay. What were your subjects in your graduation?
Sir, I had physics, chemistry, maths as the main subjects, and one more subject was English. That was only in the first year. After that, we had history as a subject in the second year.
Okay. Which all books you studied in English?
So there was only one book of English that we studied.
Okay, tell me your relationship with your mother and three things which you don't want to repeat what your mother did in her life.
Sir, my relationship with my mother is very good. She is a very calm lady, and I share a lot of things with my mother. And the thing that I think my mother should not have done is she left her studies in between, because she was a little bit hesitated in going to school. My mother has studied till class 8. After that, she left the school. Although my grandparents was able to send my mother to school, but still she left, which I think she shouldn't have left in between. And yes, sir, this is the only thing I feel that my mother has not been done.
Okay, rest everything is fine.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let's talk about your career choices which you are doing as of now. So, why do you want to join Air Force? Because you are doing something in a different stream and all. So, what is the motivation for Air Force? And which branch you want to join in Air Force?
Sir, to be very honest, I was not aware of the Indian Air Force before my post-graduation. I had very little knowledge about armed forces. But during my master's, I met one of my friends. She was preparing for the Air Force interview. I got to know about all the procedure from her. This was really encouraging for me, and I was really fascinated by all these things. I googled everything about the Air Force lifestyle, how the career thereafter. So I really felt motivated, and I thought at that time, like, this is the thing that I want to do in my life. And the motivation that I got the motivation is I belong to a background where the girls don't the privilege of study. Like in my society, most of the girls could not continue their studies because of the family pressure, because of society or some other reasons. So the motivation that I had is I want to be an inspiration for all such girls. like they should do something and they never leave their education for any reason.
Okay, that's
okay. Cool. And the branch that I want to join in the Air Force is the education.
Okay, you want to join education. How many branches are there in the Air Force? Name them.
So there is administration, logistic, aeronautical engineering, education, and flying branch.
Okay, tell me, you must have heard recently some controversy regarding a movie which has come regarding Air Force. Which is, can you talk about that?
Yes, sir. The movie that was in controversy recently was the Gunjan Saxena movie. That was based on the Indian Air Force. And the Gunjan Saxena was the girl who was the first lady to fly a helicopter in the combat area in the Kargil history. As everybody knows that the Indian Air Force is the organization where girls get the maximum respect and the safety are very good for the girls in this organization. But the movie based on Gunjan Saxena life was not up to the par.
Okay. What was the role of Indian Air Force in Kargil War?
Sir, in Kargil War, the Mirage 2000 aircraft was used and there was not much role of Indian Air Force in Kargil War as it was fought by our soldiers, and although there was only one aircraft used at that time, that is Mirage 2000.
What was that aircraft used for?
Sir, there was not much role as of I remember. Like there was that aircraft used, this much I remember, sir.
Okay. What type of aircraft does Indian Air Force has?
Sir, in Indian Air Force, we have fighter aircraft, trainer aircraft, and refueling aircraft also. And we have attack helicopters.
Okay. And what are the, is there something called as recce aircrafts also?
Sir, I'm not aware of that.
Okay. Which are the attack aircrafts which Indian Air Force has?
Sir, Tejas.
That's all?
Sir, attack helicopter, we have Apache and Chinook, Cheetah. Yes, sir.
Chinook, Cheetah, are they? Cheetah is attack helicopter?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me five technical things about Mirage 2000.
Sir, I don't know.
Okay, tell me three things about AVACS. You must have heard about that.
No.
India just recently signed a deal for AVACS. You must be knowing about that, no?
No, sir.
Okay, what do you understand by drones?
Sir, drones?
Yeah.
Sir, they are the unmanned aerial vehicle. Like, there is no pilot in these. They are used, they are controlled at a ground level.
Okay, and what is the role of Indian Air Force as of now, which is going with the confrontation in China? What is Indian Air Force is doing as of now?
Sir, Indian Air Force is like recently the Rafael we have taken. We are just building our Indian Air Force defense system strong. If in case there is any war between India and China, we have to be ready for the any situation for the future.
Anything which Indian Air Force is doing in Pangso area?
Sir, I'm not aware of it.
Okay. Indian Air Force conducts regular exercises with few countries. Name those exercises and the participation in them.
Sir, there is a Garud Shakti exercise with France and Mitra Shakti with Sri Lanka and Sampriti with Bangladesh.
That's all? What do we have with USA?
I don't remember.
No problem. Okay, tell me something about your hobbies and interests.
Sir, if I talk about my hobbies, I really like cooking, doing experiments on cooking. I love listening music and I like experimenting on new things like creating any art paintings and mehendi, etc.
What type of art are you interested in? What's the genre you work on?
Sir, I do paintings whenever I get free time. Although in the past few days, I'm not doing any kind of paintings, mehendi, etc. But earlier I used to do it. I had a sketchbook where I made paintings. The thing, whichever I like, I used to draw a sketch of it.
Okay, what type of art forms are there in painting?
Sorry, I don't know.
What type of sketches are there, which are professional sketches, sketchers made it? What are those called as?
No, sir.
What type of music do you listen?
Sir, I listen to slow music. Like I also listen Punjabi music, and my favorite singer is Arijit Singh, and I preferably listen his songs.
That's all. You said that you have an interest in music. What type of music? What all types of musics are there in our country?
Sir, we have the hip hop music and classical music also, and the Punjabi songs and that rock band type music.
That's all.
Yes.
What about your reading and all? Do you do some reading and all? Any books? Tell me the names of three books which you have recently read.
Sir, I don't read books. I just go online reading. Like whatever I feel, I think about reading something, I do it online only.
You have not read any books till now?
No, sir.
Okay. What are your other career options which you are working on if you don't get into Air Force?
Sir, if I don't get into Air Force, I will go for the teaching option. I had a chance to get a placement in the Akash Institute for teaching. So if I could not get into the Air Force, I will go for.
Okay, you must have heard about new education policy which government has laid out. Tell me three drawbacks of that education policy.
Okay, sir, in the new education policy, there has been said like the students can learn the subjects in their regional languages till class 5, which I don't think is a good option. Like the student must be good in English subject, which they find difficult later on in studying. So I think English must be compulsory from the class 1. And one more thing that I find a drawback in this is, our country has allowed to study the foreign languages in this new education policy, but the Chinese language has been dropped from these foreign languages because of the ongoing disputes between India and China, which I think is not a good option because it will automatically impact India while we are on trade with China, because communication is most important. If we could not, we are not knowing the language of China, it will automatically impact India only.
Okay, you must have heard that the induction of women has always been challenging in the armed forces. How will you handle the situation if your colleagues start misbehaving sexually with you once you join your squadron?
Sir, first of all, I don't think that in the organization like armed forces or Indian Air Force, there will be misbehave with me, because the person there are very well disciplined and obviously respect girls. But in case it happens, I will really take a stand and warn them not to do it again and make them realize their mistake.
Okay, what if you find that the people are not respecting you? Because still the patriarchal society is still there. And if you find that people under you are not respecting the troops under you, how will you handle that situation?
Sir, I believe if I am doing my work honestly and I am more focused on my work, I am taking care of all the things that are given to me, I don't think nobody will disrespect me. And if in case anybody is not respecting me, that is not a concern for me. I will focus on my work.
Okay, you spoke about China, and let's talk about that. Name few bases which China has got outside South China Sea.
Sir, I don't know about the bases, but there is a 9-9 that they have created to made an impact, like they have a dominance in the South China Sea.
That's all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, name the two aircraft. Okay, how many aircraft carriers does China has?
Sir, China has the most advanced aircraft, that is Chengdu J-20. They have Chengdu J-7 and J-10. They are also having Sukhoi 27 MKI.
And what about aircraft carriers?
Sir, I don't know.
Anything you know about Chinese air defense systems?
Sir, their defense system is large in number than as of India, and but as
what are Indian options in case of a war with China? What do you think?
Sir, I think like China and India both are the nuclear weapon countries, so there is very less chances that there will be war at a very extreme level, and there I think there will not be any war.
Okay, and what can India do in the Indian Ocean to stifle South China Sea? Okay, tell me something about energy dependency of China. Talk about that. Okay, firstly, talk about India. Energy energy reliance of India. Talk something about that.
Sir, we are dependent on Iran for the oil oil imports, and we also import so much of edible oil from the other countries. Although we have a very good agriculture in oils, but still our country is the biggest consumer of oil seeds. So we import a large number of oil from Iran, and for China, they have a South China Sea there, which is in a large source of natural gas. They import. They have an edge over energy in case as that of India.
Okay, tell me something about Gwadar port.
Sir, it's a port near Pakistan, and the China is going to use this port for their OBOR initiative, and with this port they will connect their OBOR road, and so that their transportation can be easier, and they can make their economic trade through this.
Okay, what do you understand by a squadron in Air Force?
Sir, squadron is an operational unit of Indian Air Force. There, it is basically an air base where the pilot, aircraft, etc., are inducted.
That's all. How many aircrafts are there in a squadron?
Sir, I don't know.
Who heads a squadron?
Sir, a wing commander.
What is the equivalent rank in Army and Navy?
Sir, in army, the wing commander corresponds to the lieutenant colonel, and in navy, it's equivalent to commander.
Okay, and how many squadrons does India have in total?
I don't know.
Okay, no problem. Okay, Ritu, I've seen your interview, I've seen your psychological things also. Unfortunately, maybe your efforts were not up to the mark this time. We hope that you'll come back and prepare next time. Anything, three things which you want to tell us about this center?
No, sir. Everything was good.
Okay. Any friends which you have made during this time, which you think that you will continue throughout your life?
Yes, sir. I have made a friend, Shehnaz. She is a very good nature person. And I have made a friend, Arushi, and I will continue with these friends.
Okay, how will you go back and analyze yourself, and what will you do once you go back from here?
sir, repeat the question.
We unfortunately we won't be able to select you. So what is your other option after this?
So as I said, I will opt for teaching. If I could not make it in this attempt, I will surely give one more attempt. But if I could not make it, I will opt for teaching.
Okay, we wish you all the best and safe journey home. Take care.